What's up, everybody? Welcome to the channel. Mr. Bad Boy here. I'm back again with another reaction video. So if you're first time, subscribe to the channel and join Mr. Bad Boy for the best reaction in the world, of course. So today we're gonna react to this video. Can I survive in Moscow if I don't speak Russian? So we're gonna see, can you survive in Moscow if you don't speak Russian? So let's check the video, guys.
Can I live in Moscow if I don't speak Russian? Can I move to Russia if I only speak English? These are the questions I get asked.
We're gonna see if somebody wants to move to Russia. Does he need to speak Russian?
In this video, I'm gonna tackle this topic. Do you need to be able to speak Russian if you wanna come and live or just travel in this great country?
All right.
Let's go.
Let's go. Nice. Beautiful. Beautiful Russia. Wow. Yeah, with the buildings. Buildings, always the buildings.
So you're thinking about coming to Russia and you don't speak Russian.
All right.
I get it. You don't have time to get your head down and study a brand new language. You're a busy person. But you're worried about, will it be okay? Will you be able to survive?
Yes.
So let me talk about something. First is, I understand Russian is a difficult language. It's a completely different language family to English, and many English native speakers struggle with learning a similar language like French or German. So imagine what it's like when they're trying to learn Russian. So it's okay, don't feel bad, I understand. But what about Russian people speaking English? Well, I have to say, it's the exact same situation. Russian people often find English very hard to learn.
Really?
And the percentage of Russians who speak English...
I need to go to Russia, maybe I will learn people how to speak English.
Percentage-wise.
So yeah, it will be a good thing.
St. Petersburg too. But overall, most Russians don't speak English at all. Maybe that news surprises you. Maybe it's a revelation, or maybe it doesn't surprise you at all.
The maybe the Russians, they don't like to speak English? Tell me in the comments.
Studies English at some point in their life. The vast majority study it in school, and a big percentage of those also go on to have an English class while they're in university. Mm. So why is it that they finish and they don't speak any English, or not to any reasonable level? The fact is that Russian people here don't get active practice. They studied maybe grammar and some words when they were in school, but they left the school and they never had a chance to use it. Think about maybe you're British and you studied French or German in school and you did your exams, and basically the day you left school, you forgot everything you knew. And you can probably relate to that if you're from the USA too, with your Spanish classes. You learned a few words, you did some grammar, you did your tests, and maybe now,
English is important,
later,
man.
You
can connect
some of the very basics
to anybody in
the
world.
Same here for Russians.
So it will be nice if you...
The reason your German, your French, your Spanish didn't improve was because you didn't have people to practice with. Mm. It wasn't actively being used inside your brain. And it's the exact same here for Russians and their learning of English. So because of that, there are many Russians here who don't speak any English at all. So, can you survive in Moscow if you don't speak Russian and you only speak English? Well, if we're specifically talking about Moscow, yes. This city has an abundance of English around. Almost all the restaurants in the center have an English menu. Almost all businesses have someone customer facing who speaks English. And if you're walking around the city, you're going to see English around all the time, especially because of the World Cup being here and the focus on tourists and the thought of how many more foreign people are going to come into the city.
All right.
You'll probably be safe without Russian and only English in St. Petersburg too. But for the vast majority of this country, 99%, if you don't speak Russian and you only speak English, you're going to be completely lost. We can split foreigners in Moscow into two separate groups. We can split them into the first group, which will be most of you, which will be tourists, and the other group, which will be expats. And we can tackle those both here. for tourists, if you don't speak English, you're here for, if you don't speak Russian and you're here for only a short period of time, it's absolutely no problem. You're gonna be fine here in Moscow and in St. Petersburg, no problem. Even if you have a tour guide, that would be even better to help translate maybe some things to you. Maybe you have some questions, maybe you can't read a sign because it's in Russian, you need some help. Okay, that would be good. But being here just with English as a tourist for a short period of time, no problem. However, if you're thinking about living here as an expat, I would say that Russian is absolutely essential. For almost all things in daily life, English is useless. If you need to go to the doctor, you have to speak Russian.
Wow.
If you're going to the supermarket, you have to speak Russian.
So English is not so important in Russia. You don't give it like attention in Russia.
Russian. So why is it that so many expats are here and don't speak a word?
Why?
Well, there are expat bubbles here in Moscow where English people, American people, South African people, Australian people, they all come together and they live in their little expat English speaking bubble.
Ah.
But that means they have a little bit of a social.
So they don't
English,
get social with
else.
All the Russian, like other Russian people, they don't get so much social there
help.
To help these Russian people to speak English.
Russian, and I've met lots.
Well, maybe Russians, they don't like to speak English.
They have no independence in their life, only inside their social circles. If they have any problem, they need to call a friend. Hey, will you come with me to the doctor? Hey, will you call the plumber for me? Hey, there's something wrong with my apartment. Can you call my landlord for me? Imagine being in your 20s, 30s, 40s and older and not being able to do these basic things. It's very restrictive. It's a very restrictive life.
Wow.
So in conclusion about expats, if you're happy just to be in your expat little bubble, only speak English, only socialize with English people, and need Russian people to help you with absolutely everything in life, then okay, don't learn Russian. But if you want to be a fully functioning member of society, be able to do things independently like a normal adult in any other country, then you need to have some basic elementary grasp of the Russian language. So you're an expat here, you're thinking about being an expat here. Do you need to be fluent in Russian? Absolutely not. You just need to have some basic key phrases,
yeah,
and maybe understood some words for like foods and other common things you're gonna see on a daily basis. Imagine going into a supermarket and picking up something to read the ingredients and you don't understand anything. Or you're in a restaurant which is not in the center of the city, there's no English menu, what are you gonna do? You can't ask any questions, you don't speak Russian, you can't understand the menu. So what you have to do, you point at something on the menu and hope it comes as something you like, and who knows what it might be. Maybe you have a problem in your apartment, you need to call up the landlord immediately and say, hey, something's burst, hey, the electricity's gone. How can you do that? You can't. So therefore, if you have some basic grasp of the language, it will help your life here a million times. Otherwise, you're going to be stuck with doing absolutely nothing, maybe only eating at McDonald's where you can go to the screen and press something on the screen and never have to talk to anybody.
Wow.
Is that a life you want to live? I think not. So I have to
say, yeah, it's bad.
If you're going to be an expat here, you really need to have a basic understanding, but you do not need to be fluent.
I got
but
this. Okay, so if you want to travel to Russia, you have to learn a little bit Russian.
Here in Moscow, well, if you go to an international hotel chain, people there
so English is
English.
Not so important in Russia. They don't give it like attention, too much attention in Russia.
You might have a chance of finding someone who speaks English.
Wow, it's not easy to find somebody who speaks English in Russia.
If you're working for an international business or a business which does trade with other countries, then there's always going to be people there who speak English. So there are people to meet. If you are here and you want to have a social life, then you can meet other expats, but that's all you're going to be restricted
to. So they don't get social with all the Russian, like other Russian people, they don't get so much social there to help Russian people to speak English.
Moscow is actually getting around the city is very easy.
Or maybe Russians, they don't like to speak English.
Worry about that.
I don't know.
The metro has stuff in English everywhere. The announcements are in English, the maps are in English, so that's great.
That's a good thing.
The signs on the street are all, not always, but very often, in Russian and English. If you need to get a taxi somewhere, well, I guess you could always use Uber and your app will be in English and you just type in the name of the place you want to go and you never have to discuss it with anybody, not the driver. So if you only speak English, then getting around here, it's fine. That's actually pretty easy. But I have to remind you and let me be very, very clear. Outside Moscow, St. Petersburg,
it's impossible.
And maybe some other large exceptional cities, you're gonna struggle with no Russian. English is useless in most of this country. This is from someone who's been to the north, the south, the far east and the far west of the country. If you don't speak Russian, you will have trouble. That's just a warning. So guys, thanks for watching this video. I hope it really answers some questions you had about living here in Moscow, only speaking the English language. If you liked this video or you found it helpful, please give me a thumbs up. If you have something to add, maybe a comment, maybe you think I got something wrong, or maybe you have a personal experience here speaking English in this great country, please give me a comment. And if you're interested in seeing more videos about Moscow, life in Moscow, and about Russia as a whole, please give me a subscribe. I would really, really appreciate it. Thank you very much for getting this far in the video, and goodbye.
Whoa! This video is about, you know, if somebody wants to go to live in Russia and he speaks only English. It's gonna be difficult a little bit for living in Russia and if you don't speak English. I don't know why Russians, they don't give too much attention to English and they don't care about speaking English. So I appreciate if somebody tells me in the comment why the reason the Russia they don't care a lot for the English, because the world right now, it's all about English. English is so important because it makes you connect with the world. So this is the international language. I think like he said, if you go to Moscow, if an English speaker move to Moscow, it will be a little bit difficult, not so difficult, but just a little bit, because there is some people who speak English there and stuff like that. But other cities from Russia, it will be hard, because like Petersburg, Kazan maybe, or far away cities, you will be like, you will be lost, I think. Oh, so tell me, guys, in the comment, if it's true, this what he said, it's true. Because it's hard a little bit, so Russia, they need to open themselves a little bit if it's like this, because if they want to bring tourists or so this is a surprising thing that Russia, they do, I don't know. But tell me in the comment your opinion, what you think, what this guy said, is it true? So yeah, thank you so much guys for watching, and thank you who recommend this video, this good, this interesting video, and thank you so much for all the support, all the beautiful comment, and don't forget to like and share it with your friend this video. I will see you in the next video. Take care of yourself. Mr. Bad Boy here, always with a brand new reaction.